Well, really, it's all about education because when I finished my master's degree, where I worked in Peru in an area called Paracas, and I was very interested in textiles. The most beautiful textiles in the world come from that area. And I was interested in textiles, and I was interested in pre-Columbian work, artifacts from Peru. I fell in love with Peru. And so I completed my master's degree. And I was a mother. I was going to school when I could. I didn't have time for a career as such. But then I decided that I wanted to get a PhD. And of course, there were no opportunities in Miami for me to do that either, even with Latin America being so important. So I went back to the University of Miami and I said, I want to continue and get a PhD in this subject. And I had to make it up myself. And they were very, very welcoming about that. They said, if you could find the people on the faculty to work with you, a doctorate is very independent anyway. It's not like you're sitting in a classroom the whole time. So I was lucky enough to find a historian who was a social historian interested in Peru. That was his specialty. His wife was Peruvian. And I found an archaeologist, I found an art historian. Two art historians actually, who were brave enough to take me on because they didn't know very much about the subject either. And, kind of invented my own program in Latin American studies through Latin American studies and Latin American history. And as I invented the program, actually somebody said, well, you didn't get a PhD in Latin American art history. I said, actually, my education was better because it forced me to go into history. I even had to take a course in economics, demographics. I had to do what all the Latin American studies students were doing. So it was very, very broad. It was very difficult, especially the political courses that I had to take. But I made great friends. I really felt like I learned much in a much more inclusive sense about Latin America. So I could insert the study of art in the various countries. I mean, I knew about Argentina, I knew about Colombia, I knew about Peru, I knew about the Caribbean from all of these courses I was really forced to take. So for me, when I, and all the while I was focusing on art history, I had a fellowship that required me to teach. So I had to invent the courses because there were no pre-Columbian art historian or art history courses. There were no Latin American art history. So I invented those classes, and that was an education in and by itself. So by the time I did receive my PhD many, many years later, working in colonial art from Peru, because it was impossible to return to Peru and work in the field because of the Sendero Luminoso guerrilla group, and they had ousted all foreign scholars. So the University of Miami said, no way, we are not supporting you going back there at this time. And I had fallen in love with Cusco and remembered the beautiful colonial paintings of Cusco and said, I could do a lot of this in the United States and maybe take just a few trips back and forth to Cusco. And then it opened up, so I was able to spend more time there. But the colonial art, the pre-Columbian art, served as really wonderful backdrops for contemporary art because so much of the art that happens in Latin America is based on history. So you just can't say, oh, well, I know about contemporary art and walk in the door and understand where these artists are coming from without having a background that was very inclusive. That was a bit sociology, anthropology. In fact, one of the people on my committee for the PhD was an anthropologist, a very renowned anthropologist. And so I had to look at those countries and the art being produced from so many different perspectives. And I think it served me well because it was a jump from that education into, as I said earlier, going to a gallery in Coral Gables and looking at work by Fernando de Sisla, who's one of the great Peruvian artists, and expounding on it. And the gallerist looked at me like, who are you? How do you know all this? You know, who are you? And I explained that, you know, I worked a lot in Peru, one of the new de Sisla, but better than that, I knew the myths that he was recording from the Inca perspective. I knew who those gods and goddesses were. So he was the one who said to me, you know, you really could write some catalogs for me, and you should dive into the art that is being produced in Latin America today and being brought to Miami and seen in Miami, because nobody knows it like this. So that's how I started.